Othello is a tragedy that revolves around the able Moorish general Othello, his lieutenant Cassio, his ensign Iago, and his newlywed wife Desdemona. When Othello promotes unexperienced Cassio as his lieutenant instead of Iago, Iago vows to take revenge and ruin Othello. Rodrigo, a rich man who also loves Desdemona, is manipulated by Iago. Rodrigo is promised Desdemona's love in return for money and deed. He becomes Iago's handyman. Iago and Rodrigo lie to Desdemona's father, saying that Othello stole Desdemona to marry her. Her father is at first mad, but concedes to the marriage at Othello's earnesty and Desdemona's defense of their marriage. Iago's second attempt in ruining Othello involves getting Cassio drunk and having him fight with Rodrigo. When Othello breaks up the fight, Iago feigns reluctance, but blames Cassio. Othello immediately strips Cassio of his lieutenantship. In an attempt at reconciliation, Cassio sends musicians to play under Othello's window. Although Othello denies Cassio's plea, Desdemona is sympathetic and agrees to speak on his behalf to Othello. Othello walks in the room when Desdemona and Cassio are speaking, and Cassio nervously leaves. When Othello asks Iago why Cassio was so nervous, Iago manipulates Othello's emotions and insinuates an affair between Cassio and Desdemona. Othello becomes upset, but Desdemona unintentionally exacerbates his temperament by speaking for Cassio. Cassio unknowingly becomes the victim of Iago's plotting to implicate him and Desdemona. Othello, manipulated by Iago, comes to believe that Cassio and Desdemona are indeed in an affair and becomes consumed in jealousy. Othello ultimately falls victim to Iago's machinations and is driven to murder his wife. Only at the end of the play are Iago's schemes unveiled by his wife Emilia. By then, however, it is too late.
A little song I wrote, you might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry, be happy.
Sir,
he's back.
No, man, whoa. Hey man, what's wrong with you, old man? What are you doing? Desdemona, I love her. I've been shot by Cupid. Oh, Desdemona. Oh, I love you.
Oh my god.
Oh, let's get out of here, crazy old fool.
Thank you. 18 drinking is very bad. Yo, I got a fake ID though. Yeah. Two-step with me, two-step with me. One, here comes the two to the three to the four. Everybody drunk out on the dance floor. Baby girl ass jiggle like she want.
Thank you. bad traits. You go to school and learn the golden rule. Hey.
Go.
Quit playing games with my heart. With my heart. My heart. My heart. I should have known from the start. From my heart. Should have known from the start.
Here, stand behind this bulk. Straight will he come. Where thought I could rip your bear and put it home? Quick, quick, fear nothing. I'll be at thy elbow. It makes us or it mars us. Think on that and fix most firm thy resolution.
Be near at hand. I may miscarry in it.
Here, at thy hand, be bold and take thy stand.
I have no great devotion to the deed, and yet he hath given me satisfying reasons. 'Tis but a man gone. Forth, my sword. He dies.
I have rubbed this young squat almost to the sense, and he grows angry. Now, whether he kill Cassio or Cassio him, or each do kill the other, every way makes my gain. Live, Roderigo. He calls me to a restitution large of gold and jewels that I bought from him, as gifts to Desdemona. It must not be. If Cassio do remain, he hath a daily beauty in his life that makes us me ugly. And besides, the more may unfold me to him, and there stand I in much peril. No, he must die, but so I hear him coming.
I know his gait, 'tis he. Villain, thou diest.
That thrust had been mine enemy indeed, but that my coat is better than thou knows. I will make proof of thine.
Oh, I am slain.
I am maimed forever. Help, ho, murder, murder.
The voice of Cassio, Iago keeps his word.
Oh, villain that I am.
It is even so.
Oh, help, ho, light, a surgeon.
Tis he, O brave of Iago, honest and just, that has such noble sense of thy friend's wrong. Thou teachest me. Minion, your dear lies dead, and your unblessed fate hies. Strumpet, I come. Forth of my heart those charms, thine eyes are blotted. Thy bed, lust-stained, shall be lust's blood be spotted.
What? Ho? No watch? No passage? Murder! Murder!
Tis some mischance. The cry is very direful.
Oh, help!
Hark!
Oh, wretched villain!
Two or three groan. It is a heavy night. These may be counterfeits. Let think unsafe. To come in to the cry without more help.
Nobody come? Then shall I bleed to death?
Hark!
Here's one comes in his shirt, with light and weapon.
Who's there? Whose noise is this that one's on murder?
We do not know.
Did not you hear a cry?
Here, here, for heaven's sake, help me.
What's the matter?
This is Othello's ancient, as I take it.
The same indeed. A very valiant fellow.
What are you here that cry so grievously?
Iago! Oh, I am spoiled, undone by villains. Give me some help.
Oh me, lieutenant, what villains have done this?
I think that one of them is here about, and cannot make away.
Oh, treacherous villains! What are you here? Come in and give some help.
Oh, help me!
That's one of them.
Oh, murderous slave! Oh, villain!
Oh, damned Iago! Oh, inhuman dog!
Kill me in the dark! Where be these bloody thieves? How silent is this town! Ho, murder, murder! What may you be? Are you of good or evil?
As you shall prove us, praise us.
Signor Lodovico!
He, sir.
I cry you mercy. Here's Cassio's hurt by villains.
Cassio!
How is the brother?
My leg is cut in two.
Mary, heaven forbid! Light, gentlemen, I'll bind it with my shirt.
What is the matter? Ho, who is it that cried?
Who is it that cried?
Oh, my dear Cassio! My sweet Cassio! Oh, Cassio! Cassio! Cassio!
Oh, notable strumpet! Cassio, may you suspect who they should be that slave thus may many lift you?
No.
I am to find you thus. I have been to seek you.
Lend me a garter. So, oh, for a chair, to bear him easily hence.
Alas, he faints! Oh, Cassio! Cassio! Cassio!
Gentlemen all, I do suspect this trash to be a part in this injury. Patience a while, oh good Cassio. Come, come, lend me a light. Know we this face or no? Alas, my friend, and my dear countryman. Rodrigo! No, yes, sure! Oh, heaven, Rodrigo!
What, of Venice?
Even he, sir, did you know him?
Know him, aye.
Signor Gratiano, I cry you gentle pardon. These bloody accidents must excuse my manners that so neglected you.
I am glad to see you.
How do you, Cassio? Oh, a chair, a chair!
Rodrigo!
He, tis he! Oh, that's well said! The chair!
Some good man bear him carefully from hence. I'll fetch the general surgeon. For you, mistress, save you your labor. He that lies slain here, Cassio, was my dear friend. What malice was between you?
None in the world, nor do I know the man.
What? Look you pale? Oh, bear him out of the air. Stay you, good gentleman. Look, you pale mistress. Do you perceive the ghastness of her eye? Nay, if you stare, we shall hear more anon. Behold her well, I pray you. Look upon her. Do you see, gentlemen? Nay, guiltiness will speak, though tongues were out of use. Cassio hath here been set on in the dark by Rodrigo and fellows that are escaped. He's almost slain, and Rodrigo dead.
Alas, good gentlemen. Alas, good Cassio.
This is the fruit of whoring! Verity! Amelia, go know Cassio where he slept tonight. What, do you shake at that?
He supped at my house, but I therefore shake not.
Oh, thee so! I charge you, go with me!
Thee, upon thee, strumpet.
I am no strumpet, but of life as honest as you that thus abuse me.
As I? Foe, thee upon thee.
Kind gentlemen, let's go see poor Cassio dressed. Come, mistress, you must tell another tale. Amelia, run you to the citadel, and tell my lord and lady what hath happened. Will you go on, I pray? This is the night that either makes me or furdues me quite.
It is the cause, it is the cause, my soul. Let me not name it to you, you chaste stars. It is the cause, yet I'll not shed her blood, nor scar that whiter skin of hers than snow, and smooth as monumental alablaster. Yet she must die, else she'll betray more men. Put out the light, and then put out the light. If I quench thee, thou flaming minister, I can again thy former light restore, should I repent me. But once put out thy light, thou cunningest pattern of excelling nature, I know not where is that Promethean heat that can thy light relume. When I have plucked the rose, I cannot give it vital growth again. It needs must wither. I'll smell it on the tree. O balmy breath, that dost almost persuade justice to break her sword. One more, one more. Be thus when thou art dead, and I will kill thee, and love thee after. One more, and this the last. So sweet was never so fatal. I must weep, but they are cruel tears. This sorrow's heavenly. It strikes where it doth love. She wakes.
Who's there? Othello?
Aye, Desdemona.
Will you come to bed, my lord?
Have you prayed tonight, Desdemona?
Aye, my lord.
If you bethink yourself of any crime, unreconciled as yet to heaven and grace, solicit for it straight.
Alack, my lord, what may you mean by that?
Well, do it, and be brief. I will walk by. I would not kill thy unprepared spirit. No, heaven forfend, I will not kill thy soul.
Talk you of killing?
Aye, I do.
Then heaven have mercy on me.
Amen, with all my heart.
If you say so, I hope you will not kill me.
Hum.
And yet I fear you, for you are fatal then, when your eyes roll so. Why should I fear, I know not? Since guiltiness I know not, but yet I feel I fear.
Think on thy sins.
They are loves I bear to you.
Aye, and for that thou diest.
That death's unnatural that kills for loving. Alas, why gnaw you so your nether lip? Some bloody passion shakes your very frame. These are portents, but yet I hope they do not point on me.
Peace, and be still.
I will so. What's the matter?
That handkerchief, which I so loved and gave thee, thou gavest to Cassio.
No, by my life and soul. Send for the man, and ask him.
Sweet soul, take heed. Take heed of perjury. Thou art on thy deathbed.
Aye, but not yet to die.
Yes, presently. Therefore confess thee freely of thy sin. For to deny each article with oath cannot remove nor choke the strong conception that I do groan withal. Thou art to die.
Then, Lord, have mercy on me.
I say amen.
And have you mercy, too. I never did offend you in my life. Never loved Cassio, but with such a general warranty of heaven as I might love, I never gave him token.
By heaven, I saw my handkerchief in his hand. O perjured woman, thou dost stone my heart and makes me call what I intend to do a murder, which I thought a sacrifice. I saw the handkerchief.
He found it then. I never gave it to him. Send for him hither. Let him confess the truth.
He hath confessed.
What, my lord?
That he hath used thee.
How, unlawfully?
Aye.
He will not say so.
No, his mouth is stopped. Honest Iago hath taken order for it.
Oh, my fear interprets. What, is he dead?
Had all his hairs been lives, my great revenge had stomach for them all.
Alas, he is betrayed, and I undone.
Out, strumpet! Weepest thou for him to my face?
Oh, banish me, my lord, but kill me not.
Down, strumpet!
Kill me tomorrow, let me live tonight.
Nay, and you strive.
But half an hour.
Being done, there is no pause.
But while I say one prayer?
It is too late.
My lord, what? Ho, my lord, my lord.
What noise is this? Not dead? Not yet quite dead? I that am cruel am yet merciful. I would not have thee linger in thy pain. So.
What? Ho? My lord, my lord.
Who's there?
Oh, good, my lord. I would speak a word with you.
Yes, 'tis Amelia, by and by. She's dead. 'Tis like she comes to speak of Cassio's death. The noise was here. Ha! No more moving? She still has the grave. Shall she come in? Were it good? I think she stirs again. No. What's best to do? If she comes in, she'll sure speak to my wife. My wife, my wife! What wife? I have no wife. Oh, insupportable. Oh, heavy hour! Methinks it should be now a huge eclipse of sun and moon, and that the affrighted globe should yawn at alteration.
I do beseech you that I may speak with you, oh good my lord.
I had forgot thee. Oh, come in, Amelia. Soft, by and by. Let me the curtains draw. Where art thou? What's the matter with thee now?
Oh my good lord, yonder's foul murder done.
What now?
What now, my lord?
It is the very error of the moon. She comes more nearer earth than she was wont, and makes men mad.
Cassio, my lord, hath killed a young Venetian called Rodrigo.
Rodrigo killed? And Cassio killed?
No, Cassio is not killed.
Not Cassio killed? Then murder is out of tune, and sweet revenge grows harsh.
Oh, falsely, falsely murdered.
Alas, what cry is that?
That what?
Out and alas, that was my lady's voice. Help, help, ho, help. O lady, speak again. Sweet Desdemona, O sweet mistress, speak.
A guiltless death I die.
Oh, who have done this deed?
Nobody, I myself. Farewell. Commend me to my kind lord. Oh, farewell.
Why, how should she be murdered?
Alas, who knows?
You heard her say herself, it was not I.
She said no, I must needs report a truth.
She's, like a liar, gone to burning hell. 'Twas I that killed her.
Oh, the more angel she, and you the blacker devil.
She turned to folly, and she was a whore.
Thou dost belie her, and thou art a devil.
She was false as water.
Thou art rash as fire to say that she was false. Oh, she was heavenly true.
Cassio did top her. Ask thy husband else. Oh, I were damned beneath all depth in hell. But that I did proceed upon just grounds to this extremity, thy husband knew it all.
My husband?
Thy husband.
That she was false to wedlock?
I with Cassio. Nay, had she been true, if heaven would make me such another world of one entire and perfect chrysalid, I'd not have sold her for it.
My husband?
Aye, 'twas he that told me first. An honest man he is, and hates the slime that sticks on filthy deeds.
My husband?
What needs this iteration, woman? I say thy husband.
O mistress, villainy hath made mocks with love. My husband say that she was false.
He, woman, I say thy husband. Dost understand the word? My friend, thy husband, honest, honest Iago.
If he say so, may his pernicious soul rot half a grain a day. He lies to the heart. She was too fond of her most filthy bargain.
Ha!
Do thy worst. This deed of thine is no more worthy heaven than thou was worthy her.
Peace, you are best.
Thou hast not half the power to do me harm as I have to be hurt. Oh, go, oh, dope. As ignorant as dirt, thou hast done the deed. I care not for thy sword. I'll make thee known. Though I lost 20 lives, help, help, ho, help. The Moor have killed my mistress. Murder, murder.
What is the matter? How now, General?
Oh, are you come, Iago? You have done well, that men must lay their murders on your neck.
What is the matter?
Disprove this villain, if thou beest a man, he says thou told him that his wife was false. I know thou didst not, or not such a villain. Speak, for my heart is full.
I told him what I thought, and told no more, than what he found himself was apt and true.
But did you ever tell him she was false?
I did.
You told a lie, an odious damn lie, upon my soul, a lie, a wicked lie. She was false with Cassio. Did you say with Cassio?
With Cassio, mistress. Go to, charm your tongue.
I will not charm my tongue. I am bound to speak. My mistress here lies murdered in his bed.
Oh, heavens forbid!
And your report have set the murder on.
Nay, stare not, masters. It is true indeed.
'Tis a strange truth.
Oh, monstrous act.
Villainy, villainy, villainy. I think, I smelled. Oh, villainy, I thought so then. I'll kill myself for grief. Oh, villainy, villainy.
What, are you mad? I charge you, get you home.
Good gentlemen, let me have leave to speak. 'Tis proper I obey him, but not now. Perchance, Iago, I will near go home.
Oh!
Nay, lay thee down and roar, for thou hast killed the sweetest innocent that ever did lift up eye.
Oh, she was foul! I scarce did know you, uncle. There lies your niece, whose breath indeed these hands have newly stopped. I know this act shows horrible and grim.
Poor Desdemona, I am glad thy father is dead. Thy match was mortal to him, and pure grief shore his old thread in twain. Did he live now, this sight would have made him a desperate turn. Ye, curse this better angel from his side, and fall to reprobation.
'Tis pitiful, but yet Iago knows that she was with Cassio hath the act of shame 1,000 times committed. Cassio confessed it, and she did gratify his amorous works with that recognizance and pleasant of love which I first gave her. I saw it in his hand. It was a handkerchief, an antique token my father gave my mother.
Oh God, oh heavenly powers.
Come, hold your peace.
Till well, I peace. No, I will speak as liberal as the North. Let heaven and men and devils, let them all cry shame against me, yet I'll speak.
Be wise and get you home.
I will not.
Fie, your sword upon a woman?
Oh, thou, no more. That handkerchief thou speak of, I found by fortune and did give my husband. For often with a solemn earnestness, he begged of me to steal.
Villainous whore!
To give it Cassio. No, alas, I found it. And I did give my husband.
Filth, thou liest.
By heaven, I do not, gentlemen. O murderous coxcomb, what should such a fool do with so good a wife?
Are there no stones in heaven but what serve for the thunder? Precious villain!
The woman falls. Sure, he hath killed his wife.
Oh, lay me by my mistress' side.
He's gone, but his wife's killed.
'Tis a notorious villain. Take you this weapon, which I have here recovered from the moor. Come, guard the door without. Let him not pass, but kill him rather. I'll after that same villain, for 'tis a damned slave.
I am not valiant neither, but every puny whipster gets my sword. But why should honor outlive honesty? Let it go all.
What did thy song bode, lady? Hark! Canst thou hear me? I will play the swan and die in music. Willow, willow, willow. Moor, she was chaste. She loved thee, cruel moor. So come my soul to bliss as I speak true. So speaking as I think, I die.
I have another weapon in this chamber. It is a sword of Spain, the icebreaker's temper. Oh, here it is, uncle. I must come forth.
If thou attempt it, it will cost thee dear. Thou hast no weapon, and perforce must suffer.
Look in upon me then, and speak with me, or naked as I am, I will assault thee.
What is the matter?
Behold, I have a weapon. A better never did itself sustain upon a soldier's thigh. I have seen the day that, with this little arm and this good sword, I have made my way through more impediments than 20 times your stop. But oh, vain boast! Who can control his fate? 'Tis not so now. Be not afraid, though you do see me weaponed. Here is my journey's end, here is my butt, and yet very mark of my utmost sail. Do you go back dismayed? 'Tis a lost fear. Man but a rush against Othello's breast, and he retires. Where should Othello go? Now, how dost thou look now? O ill-starred wench, pale as thy smock, when we shall meet again at Compt, this look of thine will hurl my soul from heaven, and fiends will snatch at it. Cold, cold, my girl. Even like thy chastity, O cursed slave, whip me, ye devils, from the possession of this heavenly sight. Blow me about in winds, roast me in sulphur, wash me in steep-down gulfs of liquid fire. O Desdemona, Desdemona, dead! Oh!
Where is this rash and most unfortunate man?
That's he, that was Othello. Here I am.
Where is that viper? Bring the villain forth.
I look down towards his feet, but that's a fable. If that thou best the devil, I cannot kill thee.
Wrench his sword from him.
I bleed, sir, but not killed.
I am not sorry neither. I'd have thee live, for in my sense 'tis happiness to die.
Oh, thou Othello, thou wert once so good. Fallen in the practice of a damned slave. What shall be said to thee?
Why, anything, an honorable murder, if you will, for not I did in hate, but all in honor.
This wretch hath part confessed his villainy. Did you and he consent in Cassio's death?
Aye.
Dear General, I never gave you cause.
I do believe it, and I ask your pardon. Will you, I pray, demand that demi-devil why he hath thus ensnared my body and soul?
Demand me nothing. What you know. From this time forth, I never will speak word.
What, not to pray?
Torments will ope your lips.
Well, thou dost best.
Sir, you shall understand what hath fallen, which, as I think, you know not. Here is a letter found in the pocket of the slain Roderigo, and here another. The one of them imports the death of Cassio to be undertook by Roderigo.
Oh, villain!
Most heathenish and most gross.
Now here's another discontented paper, found in his pocket too. In this, it seems, Roderigo meant to have sent his damned villain. But that belike Iago, in the interim, came in and satisfied him.
Oh, the pernicious caitiff. How came you, Cassio, by that handkerchief that was my wife's?
Found it in my chamber, and he himself confessed, but even now that there he dropped it for a special purpose, which wrought his to his desire.
Oh, fool, fool, fool!
There is besides in Roderico's letter how he upbraids Iago that he made him brave me upon the watch, whereon it came that I was cast, and even but now he spake. After long seeming dead, Iago hurt him. Iago set him on.
You must forsake this room and go with us. Your power and your command is taken off, and Cassio rules in Cyprus. For this slave, if there be any cunning cruelty that can torment him much and hold him long, it shall be his. You shall close prisoner rest, till that the nature of your fault be known to the Venetian state. Come, bring him away.
Soft you, a word or two before you go. I have done the state some service, and they know it. No more of that. I pray you, in your letters, when you shall these unlucky deeds relate, speak of me as I am, nothing extenuate, nor set down aught in malice. Then must you speak of one that loved not wisely but too well, of one not easily jealous, but being wrought, perplexed in the extreme, of one whose hand, like the base Indian, threw a pearl away, richer than all his tribe, of one whose subdued eyes, albeit unused to the melting mood, drop tears as fast as the Arabian trees, their medicinal gum. Set you down this, and say besides, that in Aleppo once, where a malignant and a turbaned Turk beat a Venetian and traduced the state, I took by the throat the circumcised dog and smote him thus. Ugh.
Oh, bloody period.
All that spoke is marred.
I kissed thee ere I killed thee. No way but this, killing myself to die upon a kiss.
This did I fear, but thought he had no weapons, for he was great of heart.
O Spartan dog, more fell than anguish, hunger, or the sea, look at the tragic loading of this bed. This is thy work. The object poisons sight. Let it be hid. Gratiano, keep the house, and seize upon the fortunes of the Moor, for they succeed on you. To you, Lord Governor, remains the censure of this hellish villain. The time, the place, the torture, oh, enforce it. Myself will straight aboard, and to this state, this heavy act with heavy heart relate.
See it through, 'cause you've got a friend. more than I am, big and stronger too. Maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, a friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.